California water plant. How about California water action plan? Fellow Toastmasters and guests, today I would like to talk about California water action plan. The California water action plan is the plan, especially it is a roadmap put forward by Governor of California for the sustainable use of surface as well as groundwater resources in the state of California so as to achieve the equitable goals and provide water to all the communities in each and every region in the state. California Water Action Plan is a subset of California Water Plan, where California Water Plan is being upgraded by Department of California Water Resources, but it is a subset of California Water Plan where the actions and implementation of those policies are applied. So that plan helps all the stakeholders, regional as well as state agencies, federal agencies, as well as local agencies, work together to achieve the goals for sustainable water resources for the future of them. Of course, we know that we are now living in the reality of drought as well as in flood. So when there is a drought, there is not flood, but when there is a flood, there won't be drought. So we are having in the stage where we do not have any year with a normal precipitation. So because of this, we are having so much challenges, especially to resolve the issues of water supply, water availability, and water convenience. Therefore, the Governor of California wrote this California Water Action Plan in 2014, and it goes up to 2018. So 4 years plan has different action. So there are 10 different action items on the California Water Action Plan. Based on those actions, all those administrator and governor, they can allocate the funds, like fund coming from bond fund or from grant. They allocate those funds in order to achieve the goals of those actions. So first action on the California Water Action Plan is make conservation a way of California life. Wherever we are in the state of California, whether we are in the Los Angeles or in the North Coast, what governor wants us is the conservation is our way of life. So everywhere when we use water, whether it is indoor water use or it is outdoor water use, we need to think from the conservation point. Because of that, we will be able to conserve our water resources by 25% by year 2020. Of course, we know that SPX 2020 by 2020 is the target goal of achieving 20% water conservation method, but because of last year's drought, governor already upgraded that to 25%. Therefore, we are obligated to conserve our water resources to 25%. So that is the first action that will tell all of us to conserve our water resources. And the second item, increase regional self-reliance and integrated water management across all levels. So what is this is that governor would like to have the self-reliance to all those regions. For example, if we talk about the regional agencies or local level, like San Bernardino County Water Districts, so those areas, governor wants them to be self-sustainable by themselves. How? By conserving the existing water resources, utilizing the water resources in an optimal manner, and also recharging the groundwater levels, and also capturing the stormwater runoff during the rainy season, and then recharge the groundwater resources. And in addition to that, upgrading and managing the watershed so that the erosion and deposition problem will not happen. So this is how we would be able to sustain the integrated water management issues in this area. So third item is achieve the co-equal goals of the Delta. Of course, we know that we have been struggling with several political as well as other economic and also ecological issues in and around the Delta. Because of that, we do not have a way to convey our surface water resources from north to south. That's why what governor wants here is to convey the existing water resources such that we do not harm our existing ecological situations, and at the same time convey the water resources so that we can provide that water to the south. That's why all those twin tunnel concept, Bay Delta Conservation Plan, they came into action. So those program and plans are based on this action plan. And action item number 4 is protect and restore important ecosystem. So this action item helps all the governor and its administrator to protect our ecosystem, not in and around the Delta, but in other areas such as Dalton Sea habitat restoration. And the community restoration project in Lake Tahoe area, and the mountain meadow habitat restoration projects in our Sierra Nevada area. So these are the area where the budget has been focused in order to make sure that ecosystem and habitat is being always safe and sustainable in a long run. And item number five is manage and prepare for dry years. Of course, how we are going to manage and prepare? We would like to allocate the funds to help those communities who are based in need of the resources during dry years, and at the same time, use the existing resources in an optimum manner and work with local agencies to get some expertise and skills in order to improve those existing projects, such as maintain and operate those resources in an optimum manner. So that's how we can achieve the goals and be prepared for the dry years. And item number 7, provide safe water to all communities. Of course, we know that we are having issues regarding the water quality problems. So many groundwater basins in our Southern California, such as the Los Angeles basins and San Bernardino basins, are having contaminated. Therefore, governor wants to clean and remediate those basins so as to aid additional groundwater resources to those communities. So this is how governor would like to achieve the goals to obtain the safe as well as clean water resources. And item number 8, increase flood protection. Of course, we have been working to increase the flood protection. We have been improving our existing flood resource infrastructure, and we have increasing our monitoring activities to those levees, and also we are trying to strengthen our dams and reservoirs, and also increasing additional projects to aid additional flood protection infrastructure. So this is how we can improve our ability to protect by ourselves through all those flood disasters. And item number 9, increase operational and railroad efficiency. Of course, by improving the efficiency of the administrations, governor would like to improve the efficiency and expedite the water transfer process. And item number 10 is identify sustainable and integrated financing proposal. Governor would like to attract all those donors and all those investors in water energy nexus projects so that water resource projects, additional projects, will be launched in the future. So this is how the overall